78 people have now died in the Assam and Meghalaya floods. 10 lakh people across 13 districts have been affected and rendered homeless in Assam alone. Though the rain has stopped and water is slowly receding, huge tracts of human habitation remain underwater. As the focus shifts to rebuilding, the emphasis will also be on rebuilding road infrastructure in Meghalaya, with rural roads severely damaged. Even the roads that have opened up have slippery slush, meaning the trucks carrying essential supplies still cannot pass through.
This is what has become of the national highway that connects Assam to the Meghalaya town of Tura. Landslides at many places, meaning that vehicles are having a very tough time in actually navigating this highway and going all the way to Tura, which is the main town of the Garo Hills. These passenger taxis have only just started plying after being unable to commute on this road over the last 3 or 4 days. The road has just opened up, but even now it is very difficult to actually pass these stretches where there is a lot of mud, a lot of landslides, as you can see. And that's why communication to the town of Tura and onwards to the entire Garo Hill region is still very, very bad, in a bad shape. It will take a few days before this mud dries out in case there is no further rain. And then perhaps the agencies here responsible for maintaining this road will be able to clear out this mud and slush and hope and ensure that road connectivity improves into Garo Hills. At the moment, like I said, vehicles having a tough time navigating these stretches, and there are many on the road to Tura in Meghalaya. With cameraperson Sanjoy Chakravarti, this is Alok Pandey, NDTV.